Okay, so this is a problem where we're interested in fitting the kinetics for this reaction here, where the two reactants are in a 2-to-1 ratio, and also the feed ratio, importantly, it's going to make the math simpler, is in a 2-to-1 ratio. And we want to basically solve for the reaction order with respect to A, which I'll call alpha, and we'll want to solve for the rate constant for component A. Okay, and we're furthermore interested here, or we see here that the experimental data is plotted in a form of the log of a rate versus the log of a concentration, which suggests a differential form of analysis, so we'll probably be wanting to take the derivative of our material balance. But first we'll go ahead and set up the material balance. We can postulate a power rate law as being equal to the rate, where the rate of formation of C is equal to a K defined on the basis of A that we're looking for, times a concentration of A, times a concentration of B. And these can be raised to two different powers. We know that the concentration of A is raised to an alpha power that we're, again, solving for, and the concentration of B, according to the problem statement, will be raised to the first order, because we're given that the reaction order has previously been determined to be 1.0 in the concentration of B. All right, one nice thing about this kind of setup is that we know that because the feed is stoichiometric and you're always consuming 2 moles of B for every mole of A you consume, and you start with twice as much B as A, then you're always going to have the case that the concentration of B is equal to twice the concentration of A. And so this allows us to do a substitution of variables so that we get a Ka times a concentration of A to the alpha times 2CA, which allows us to replace one of our unknowns with another one. All right, now we can collect terms and take the logarithm of both sides. So we can take the log of RC and have that be equal to the log of 2 times Ka, if we collect those terms, plus alpha plus 1, if we collect the two exponents here by multiplying Ca to the alpha power, times Ca to the first power, times the logarithm of Ca. And now we see we're already in a very convenient form for our analyzing our batch reactor experiment here, that the slope of a plot of the log of the rate versus the log of Ca is equal to alpha plus 1. And that's been determined in an Excel fit of being 1.51. So therefore, alpha is approximately 1/2. Okay, the intercept has k in it, and so that allows us to solve for k. And so we can just simply set log of 2ka equal to the intercept here of negative 5.30. And finally, solve for ka. I get ka being equal to 2.5 times 10 to the minus 3 in terms of the number. And now, one thing you have to pay careful attention to here is the units. Right, you have to go back to the original expression to get the units. All right, we know that RC in the problem statement is given to us in terms of moles per liter minute on the left-hand side, right? And CA is going to be in terms of moles per liter, and we know now it's to the half power. And CB is in terms of moles per liter also, according to the problem statement. All right, but that's raised to the first power. And so in order to make the units work out, Ka is just a proportionality constant, and so we need the units to be this, so that RC will be in moles per liter per minute.